embrasser, de nous flatter, de nous jeter comme des jouets. A trop jouer à celui qui ment, ils ont trahi ton serment. Songe à toutes les galères dont on ne peut plus se défaire. L'enfer c'était hier, ce soir nos rêves sont durs comme fer.
Piquer, piquer, Instagram, à leur tour de dormir dehors. Pour ma part, je vais rêver.
Hello and welcome. Let me know about audio levels, first and foremost, and welcome everybody. But, like, audio levels, important, because I don't know. hype. I don't know if they're too loud or if, because the songs also fluctuate, but I have a whole playlist ready. And with that, I mean all the songs of the musical. Haha. I am prepared. But yes. Let us go to... Boom. A little quiet. Okay. I can... Maybe this? Because they also have lyrics and I don't want people to get confused. Hello Kira! Who's ready? I'm kind of excited about this, if you can tell. It's just fun. You should have brought Smash quiet? Okay. Yeah, just let me... You can tell me per song, really, because, like I said, it's just audio levels. I don't know. We'll see what happens. Is it better? Okay. Just let me. Anyways. Okay, great. A fairy. Thank you. Yes. So... Let's see how this is going to go, because she's probably... So, let me set the stage. Who? Okay, I have to keep watch over the... But anyway, let me set the stage for you. Pun intended. Well, not really, but what? You know what I mean. So, you come in, the music starts. Not this song, let me just. Music starts. And you get. A bit of backstory for our main protagonist before we get into the whole storming of the Bastille kind of thing, because that's what this is about. This is going to be a drawthrough of 1789, Les Amants de la Bastille. I was free enough to So, there you have it. The curtains draw open and we are met with the first scene. Yeah, this is the only one I prepared, so don't worry about it. I didn't do too much. And even this one I did without reference. But yes. We are a bit away from Paris. 1 year before the revolution. And we are met with our main character. I mean... Do you guys want to name them or should I just give you their names? Hey Oods!
Oh,
No, long hair doesn't. Yes, it's. We. Okay, let me just. We can get into names later, but let's. For clarity, let's just say. We have our protagonist. This guy, who is very aggressive. His name is Ronan. And Ronan is a bit angry because we are out of Paris in a lovely little village, and unfortunately the soldiers of the king have decided to rampage that village. And one of the things that happened during the rampage is the confrontation between the villagers and the soldiers. And we have the soldiers here, led by the Count of Payroll, Lazare. Very important figure, we'll come back a lot later. And Oops should know this one, because Oops has drawn herself as Lazare. So we have Ronan and Lazare, and they're getting a bit into a scuffle because, you know, Ronan thinks that the soldiers shouldn't do this, and Lazare really doesn't give a shit. So, you know, opposing stuff. So they get into a bit of a scuffle, the villagers, the soldiers, and you have Ronan's sister, Selene, otherwise known as the Bread Whore. Thank you, Troy, for having me say that out loud. But she isn't a Bread Whore yet, so let's not. Long hair don't care, yes. Long hair don't care, really, that's what he is. He really doesn't care. Anyways, so yeah, we have a bit of a scuffle. As I said, we have Ronan, Selene, and the villagers, including their parents on one side, and the soldiers, led by Lazare, who are on their way to Paris. But then things go a little wrong. As you can see, I have the titles of the song. I gave myself, unlike Chris, I did a bit of preparation for this and gave myself a bit of help by having the title of the song. So now we get the preludes, the instrumental is over, and we get... I know it's against the rules to prepare for anything, but, you know, I had to. Yes. So we get to the first real song. Which is sung... which is sung by Selene. Otherwise known as Bread Whore. But she's not a Bread Whore yet, so keep that in mind. Let me see if I can find the song in particular to help me a bit. There we go. It's a sad song. Because we so we have the soldiers, we have the villagers. This is going to be great. I really... How do you draw? I have drawn this whole day and I still... really just decide to do this way, huh? No, it's not the song about being thirsty for bread. It's a bit sad because well, just let me, if I can remember how to draw a correct person body, human body, as some would call it, then maybe if for sure something like this. Anyway, I should finally finish that sentence. I'm a bit jittery now. Yes, so we have the scuffle, which I have mentioned 45,000 times already, between the soldiers and the villagers, and well, things as usually between when things go wrong between soldiers and villagers, they usually go really wrong. And well, you know, people just get a bit hurt, maybe most of the time. Because, you know, a bit of a kerfuffle, yes. So the soldiers get away with what they're doing, but yeah, the villagers aren't really lucky in that regard. So pretty much a lot of them die. Or get wounded or whatever you wanna call it. That's not, no. Never mind. Whatever. I can speak, I promise. This is what human figures look like when they lie on the ground. So yeah, I have a lot of space left here, but whatever. So but you know, Selene and her main character of a brother survive because we do need a story. This musical didn't end in 5 seconds. Hey miss, how you doing? Ice, whatever. You know what? We're going to do this a lot simpler because I'm going to have to draw a lot of faces. So we're going to have. Nope. Nope. She has to be sad. And then. Whoop. Whoop. Sad eyebrows. And I believe I gave her like. Just love. Darn straight, Selene. Yeah, Selene survives. She's going to come back in the story, after all. This is what hair looks like. Well, it's what hair looks like, but it's not what her hair looks like. But you know what? We're going to. She does have an ear. and you. I don't remember what outfit did I get. Let's be a bit consistent. Okay, something. Something like this. Just also reminder that for the first drawing, I also didn't use reference. You don't have any reason to believe that, but I didn't, and that's why all the characters will be very, very accurate. Thank you very much. Okay, for a bit of this, let's be a bit accurate. But I think your guys are going like this girl more than you guys are already doing because of the whole Bradford thing. But she's a pretty cool character. Because, well, I won't spoil it. But she has a few other songs in this musical, which are pretty important. Okay. Wow. Skills. Drawing skills. Chris, how do you do this? I don't know. Good enough. I'm making him look like Ronan. Oh no, Uncle. Wow, I must be really out of it if I refer to Dutch suddenly. But he is not fun. Let's give him a ponytail. There. Now you know for sure he's not fun. No, that's fine. I mean, it's all fine, it's pretty. Let's give him a little thingy. But I am more of a real, like, watcher. I can't listen to things. I get distracted really easily when I'm not watching it, and I don't, like, get any of it. Should really. There. That's. Oh wow, that torso to leg ratio doesn't make any sense. You didn't find one with subtitles. Really? I mean, strange, because I know there is one. Doesn't have the best audio quality, but you know, you have to, like, take what you can get with this. I don't know. On YouTube, yes. That head, why? Let me just make your head a little smaller, dude. And then we can move on to the second song when we play. Because technically this is all still part of the prologue. Whatever. And they just got them. Not sure. We're not going to. Okay. Sorry if I'm still a bit sniffly and coughy and like sick. By the way, still feel a lot better, but I'm still not fully there. oops, mood. Don't know how often I've done it. But anyway, we end the prologue. Selene has sung her sad song, Le Cri de ma naissance. About what happened that night. How terrible. I know sorry is the right word, but you can't correct me on that, miss. But yeah. About what happened that night and how much it is worth to knock off the Alfredo Pretor and put the full gym. Wait. I don't know. Are those all different people or. But. Like, what is it worth to. Yeah. To save a man? Or what is it worth? How man is a man's life worth? Which is pretty much a message that keeps returning throughout the musical. There's a whole song about it. So the curtain sets, well, set, I don't know. It gets dark, the prologue is over. We skip ahead to 1789. Move ourselves to Paris, city of love, city of light? No, probably not. I don't know, the city of something. Selene and Ronan move to the city of Paris, but a bit out of Paris, I believe. There is another place that's very important to our story, where we will meet our second main character. We go to Versailles, and we meet the king and queen. I'm making this very dramatic. But let me get her song. There you are. Where Dave. It is very good. It's such a like departure from like the first bit where like everything is serious, and it's just it illustrates its point so well. Just the whole thing is amazing. Also, I like the dude in pink was just there to be like weird. Like I don't, there is, he has no role there but like announcing the king and queen and being weird. Like, it's amazing. Sorry. Anyway, I don't know what her wig looked like. I can't remember for the life of me. But whatever. It's a wig. But we go to Versailles, and we are met with the king and queen of France, partying, being lavish, being like just really not caring about what's going on in the rest of the world or in, even in our own country. They just want to party, continue party, don't care about anything but themselves. And being the bourgeoisie. Yes. Well, not really, not in this time yet. It's more like being the aristocracy. It's not like it, it's just that is it. But anyways, we are met with Marie Antoinette, but we are also met with another woman. If I can draw her. If I can draw a good person today. I mean, that's what eventually will happen, but not in this musical. Because, okay, we have our second protagonist that we meet at the palace. Because, if I can draw a torso right, but nope. Thank you. But we have our second protagonist. We are met with Olympe, I think. I'm making it really tall, but whatever. Because the queen has children, and those children need a family too. And that's what Olympe is for. Hey Triforce, welcome back. I am not going to bother drawing proper hands. Whatever. Chris does that, but Chris is better than me, so you know. Yes, exactly, miss. Get children, but don't look after them, because that's what other people are for, you know? You're the queen of France. You can't be bothered to look after your own children. Something. That's what they all were. Ruffles. And this. also a mess. That's really funny to me. But anyways, we have our queen. We have our king, who is not very important. I mean, he's there. But he doesn't have a song. He is an actor, not a full singer and actor, like some of the others, like the queen. But I mean, they're partying, they're having a good time. Lamp is watching over the children. During the party, Marie Antoinette goes she speaks to her what do you call someone who's like with the queen and knows all her secrets and a trusted person. Confidant, yes. Thank you. Thank you, Trey. She tells her confidant that she's going to meet, well, her husband has already caught her with another dude a few times. And her husband didn't like that so much, and her lover was sent out of Paris and stuff. But her confidant tells her that that her lover is back in Paris and wants to meet her. And Marie Antoinette is very happy about it, and she wants to meet him very, very much, even though her confidant really tells her not to, because that's not a great idea. And because who knows what will happen, and you have to meet in the city, and you know, could be dangerous because there are all sorts of revolutionaries out there and such. But the queen wants to go, and what the queen wants, she gets. And it's, but someone else has heard the conversation. Someone who works for her, I think, brother-in-law? Anyway, I think it's brother-in-law, yes, because brother of the king. The Count of Artois, who wasn't named, I believe. This is how you hold a fan. But the Count of Artois gets told of the queen's adventure. By a very inconspicuous person. Sorry, I'm just having so much fun. How am I going to... Sure, let's go just... They went full up with the thing, so I'm going to go full out as well. Um, how I'm going to... He still was wearing pants, but it was like hiked up or something. Or short. Was it short? How does that make any sense? I don't know how... He was wearing a wig as well, I think. And I'm just trying to remember the picture Chris drew, because for some reason that's... more... I remember that better, but I still don't remember it great. But he did have like a wig, I think, for this one instance. Usually he's like bald, but who knows, let's just give him a little... something like this. anyway. I don't remember what he did with the thing. Let's just say it was something like this. Yes, I should probably explain it. What I'm drawing here. Because you know that's pretty important. Yes. Shoe, whatever. Okay. So, try, I will explain. We have gone to, from to Versailles. We were the king and queen are having a party, as they have every day. Every single day they have a party pretty much. We have the queen in the middle. We have on the right we have a bomb who takes care of the queen's children. The queen talks to her confidant and says well, she hears that her lover is back in Paris. She doesn't want King to know for rather obvious reasons, but she wants to meet with her lover anyways, so she will go. She agrees to go into Paris, and one of the background dancers is revealed to be Auguste Ramar. And Ramar is the king's brother's spy. He's not great. He's not great at his job. He's rather funny, bit of comic relief. But he crossbred, got to hear what the queen and her confidant had to say, and gets ordered by the Count of Artois, the prince, the king's brother essentially, that he needs to follow the queen and make sure she's safe and doesn't come across any things that might hurt her, or things that might benefit from knowing who she is, like revolutionaries and stuff. He's the best. I mean, sure. I'm sure he's the best at one of the things he's supposed to do. So... yes, essentially, well, yeah. He is sent out to protect the queen, but mostly from revolutionaries and other people from finding out who she is and maybe using her or imprisoning her or cutting off her head or something like that. Anyways, so we leave Versailles. Yes, thank you, miss. We leave Versailles and we move on to the next song. Oh, crap. Oh, goodness. Oh, no. Oh, boy. How am I going to draw this? Oh, no. Anyway, we get to Paris. Let me put up the song. I don't know how I'm going to draw this, but whatever. Okay. Because there are going to be a lot of people in this scene. But let's start with the more obvious one. The singer of this song. I see that people have already, when people, I mean, Fry has already guessed one of the people who is going to be in this scene. But first we get to the rest. And with the rest I mean all the revolutionaries that I'm going to have to draw. Well, not all of them really, I believe. Thingamabob gets introduced later during I believe he gets only mentioned now, maybe. Hello, human figure, thank you. But yeah, we get introduced to the revolutionaries. We first get introduced with the person I'm not drawing, which is Camille Desmoulins. He is pretty much the leader of what is currently known as the revolution. He is also the writer of the revolution. And I'm not trying him at the moment. But Ronan is also there, this suit. Ronan has found his way into Paris, and because of his mistreatment by the soldiers and negligence by the crown, he has decided to join the revolutionaries. So we get reintroduced to Ronan and to the to Desmoulins, and yeah, they seem pretty close friends. They Ronan helps Desmoulins with, like, because Desmoulins is like the writer, he, I don't know if he works or owns or like where the press, I don't know what it's called in English, the thing, I mean, I think it's just press, the thing where like letters and pamphlets and such gets pressed, but I don't know, can't be sure. It's English. Printing press, yes. How do you draw someone? That's like a reasonably cocky expression. Yeah. But then we get the song. I don't know why I decided to throw this one first. It doesn't make any sense with the way I'm done. But whatever. You don't always make logical decisions. But this is fuck. Got his name. Why? What's your name again? I forgot what your name. I forgot his name. I remember his first name, which is not mentioned in the musical, by the way. But I don't remember what his last name is, which is how he is called the whole musical. Oh god. I know his first name is George. Georges. But I can't for the life of me remember what his last name is. I don't know. I don't remember. But we have Georges. Who does his song and dance with a lot of prostitutes in the background, because that's important for his characterization. And we have with him a little girl with a beret. Bonbon. Thank you. Miss, you're a lifesaver. Thank you. Drawthrough. Yes. I couldn't for the life of me remember what he was called. You can name them. I need to squish you. You can name them, but also I am, for my own sake, I am calling them by their own names. But with him is a little girl called Charlotte. And Charlotte is pretty cool. Also, she has a gun. I think, for some reason. That's way too long torso. Nope. What do you have? A gun. Holds gun. First your arm needs to be short. Suddenly I am concerned about the proper anatomy of a child. Yes. I don't know. How do you hold something like this? It's like one of those guns that's really just a like that. Yes. Please do try. I will be looking forward to them. It's like long coat. But yeah, Charlotte is here. And she is very cute and very determined, and just hangs around really from the rest of the musical, does some things, why did it just suddenly change color? There we go. She's also at the top. Yes. Let me take a sip. What a beautiful drawing I've made. Yes. And yeah. So we have Bonal, who has gained a red scarf thingy, I believe, because he's now part of the revolution, and he's not really impressed by the rest of the revolutionary gang, but whatever. He's a peasant, so whatever. You know, that's what they all do. He's like, would be much better if something actually were to happen. And the rest are like, yeah, but we can also like use writing and such. It's like, I'm a peasant, I can read, or whatever. I don't remember exactly the details. So he's like, whatever, I want to fight. And no one else wants to fight. Because fighting is stupid. And we have Dumana, who I'm not going to... can put a lot of effort in later. because he has a whole song and I'm not going to be sure what his role is up for it. So I'm not going to bother much with him now. He was just busy. Yeah, sorry. Let me turn on the lights for a sec. I need to see. Scarves are the most important part of every revolution. Scientifically proven. The only thing he was wearing, he was like wearing a vest, a waistcoat. Me, saying I'm not going to put in any effort. He was definitely wearing a waistcoat, me saying. Says I for 5 seconds later. And like bunched up things and whatever. He was like busy. He was writing or something. Apparently he's writing on his hands. That's sure. I don't push myself too much. Trust me, I'm going really easy on myself. Like, I'm usually not happy with this kind of quality, but you know, you gotta take what you get. And I'm really not going to bother with great rhymes. It's just about the story. Whatever. Doesn't have girls, but that did he have one tail probably? Everyone was not that just he is not angry. Should be clear. He is like decent. Like I don't know, whatever. So we have our scene. We have Dumoulin and Ronan who are talking together. Ronan has joined the revolution, but is generally unsatisfied with it because he wants like really seen something done. Like he has seen what like soldiers of the king has done, he has seen how little they got compensated for it, and he is trying to make things right. Try force, please. Ronan tells Dumoulin, who is on the far left. We have Dumoulin, Ronan. You are Ronan. You had that right. I gave Danton. I gave to Crow for... Yeah. And Charlotte I gave to Lewis, which he was not very satisfied with. And Zumana hasn't been given to anyone. Because, I don't know, it's not very interesting. Does have a song, but even that one is not. But, wait. Ronan, unsatisfied, talks to Dumoulin. Dumoulin introduces him to Danton, who just happens to arrive at the place where they're gathering, the Palais Royal. And he comes with little tiny Charlotte, and they do the big song and dance. And Ronan is even more unsatisfied because Danton is very flamboyant and like doesn't seem to really care about the revolution, not from what Ronan can see. So he is still left unsatisfied. But then like Danton jokes around a bit because that's just his personality, really. And he talks about the prostitutes who are like nearby, and like he found someone to like, you know, you know, I don't have to say it. So we get a bit of an awkward situation on our hands as Solane enters the scene as the one Danton was talking about. Which is a bit awkward for Ronan, because Ronan didn't know anything about what Slane was doing. So he's a bit pissed. But when is he not? I mean, really. But, Ronan demands an explanation, and Solane basically says what Missa said, a girl's gotta eat. And Ronan has been very like busy with all the revolutionary stuff and not really paying attention to her, or like food. So Selene decided to take matters into her own hand by selling her body, which I think is pretty legit, really. Like, just out of like most, like, a girl's gotta eat. And yeah, so I think she's pretty much right in like what she decided to take medicine into her own hands, and I respect it, really. And also she's pretty important later, but whatever. Selling her butt. I mean, kind of, I guess. She's a prostitute. So, don't know what expression I want. Mad, I guess. She's pretty mad at Ronan. Going home. Because, you know, she wanted food, which is, I think, pretty reasonable, really. Like, pretty reasonable demand. And Ronan wasn't doing anything. So, you know, whatever. But Ronan gets a bit mad because sister is now a whore. A bread whore. So, you know. And, I don't know, she is not very happy about it either, but she has to do something. There aren't a lot of options for a lady, a peasant lady in France in, like, the 18th century. So, yeah. So, because Ronan is very mad, he is very, very mad. And Selena isn't happy either. So, Selena decides that if Ronan doesn't want to take care of her, and he also doesn't want to accept that she's taking care of things herself, then she's just not going to interact with him anymore. Because she's had enough of that. She no longer cares, she just wants food in her belly. And she really doesn't care how she's going to do that. And, what's the next? Yeah. That's where we enter the next song. Again, sung by Selene. Who is basically explaining to the public, That's where she stands. She can't really do anything anymore. Siblings are very angry. Yeah. They end up parting ways. Most of the rest of the musical. Because Ronan is being a bit of a shithead. And Selene wants food. Thank you. Okay. I think I should have accepted that this was that the question was coming. There we go. What is it, right? Go find that food, miss. God, this pose. I didn't play the song that's playing right now in the musical. I mean, you know what I mean. I may do that for a second. Which was not really my. There we go. Angry pissed. Cause angry. trailer. That's not how this goes. Miss. Don't worry about it. I almost said it a few times as well. That's like bindings or whatever. Hooray for unnecessary detail. Oop. That's not what I want. In a weird way, I'm kind of happy with this drawing. It really doesn't look like I drew it, but you know what? I'll take it. Anyway. Okay, good. So you don't know everything, which is nice. Going to be plenty of surprises. And? Anyway. So. Just in time with the song review. The song ends. Thanks guys. So we have our. Okay, good. Thought for a second that it froze, but it's just on my phone. Which is good. Warm breath. So we have our sibling fight, and we move on, they part ways, and we go on to the next song, which is, oh dear, what happens? Oh no. I'm going to have to think of what happens. I know. Okay, I think I know what happens. Someday don't save you. We have oh, I thought for a second that this was the song that was playing right now, but it isn't. You guys are too nice. Anyway, we Ronan and Selena part ways, Ronan realizes he no longer has a place to stay. Or, I don't know. I'm not sure if he didn't already before, or I don't think they had a place to stay. But now he double doesn't have a place to stay because his sister is no longer with him. So he stays at the night at on a bench outside at the Palais Royal, where we just were. Was the whole song about this song? Coincidentally, this whole song is about the Palais Royal. Someone else, come to Palais Royal that night as well. Um, one of them being the queen, who will has agreed to meet up with her lover, and she have at least you know, well, not she, but like her confidant, probably, had at least the common sense to make her hide her herself with like a cloak, just in case anyone would recognize. Doesn't do much, but at least it's something. More than the queen would have thought. Anyway. Just saying the truth. No, you guys are nice. It's nice. On a hand or something. Very proper and such. Still see a little like hair roll or whatever it's called. And probably a face. Most people have faces. Girl? And she's like very happy. Because she's going to see the person who cares about her. That's not a happy expression, money. Whatever. Good. And with her is Lady Olamp, who has decided to come with her just in case something were to happen. You think there are a lot of people without faces out there? I don't know. Maybe. Never seen one though. Not in real life. She's like a bit more worried. Like, I don't know, what if something is going to happen? I don't know, I think we should go back probably, but we can't go against the queen, so guess we'll stay here with her, but really don't feel good about this. Flavor text. Probably not what she says. Mostly because it's in French. But you know, still worried. Worried and like, you kind of had something like this. Just like general. She has like more curls, but not like big curls. Like this, maybe? Something. Maybe on the shoulder. No, not the shoulder. Like, falls up behind her, I think. Whatever. for a lump, this is kind of a departure from watching over Louis the something or another. The 17th, probably. Because, you know, 16 was the one that was killed, so. Probably 17. So she's a bit worried. But you know what? She gotta do what she gotta do. Soon. Also, hands in front of her because that's relatively easy to draw. Let's finish this hair. And let's move them ahead a bit. Sorry for coughing right anyway. And they're also followed by a mysterious figure. You know who it is. I mean, someone was ordered to follow them, so it's pretty obvious who it is, but you know what? Supposed to be a mysterious figure who follows. Always forget that the thing goes over the knee. Haha, I know how another knee works. Promise. Looks like he's pointing. He's not pointing. I just can't be bothered to draw a proper head. You know, sure, good enough. Oh, because I moved the thing and this is on the thing, of course. Well, that's lost forever, I guess. Oopsies. And, we have like, on a bench. Well, it looks really a bench, or like. We have, hold on, peacefully kind of peacefully sleep. Sleeping on a bench outside, because that's where he has ended up. That's why he wants to fight for, like, the commoners. Because he doesn't want anyone else to sleep. just say he doesn't want anyone else to sleep? I mean, on the bench, but... you know? Sure. Still has this scarf and shoulder. Thank you, Emily. He doesn't want anyone else to sleep. End of sentence. This for shoes look like just blocks. We have him relatively peacefully sleeping out on the streets. He is noticed, just like so many others who are sleeping out of the streets. But he's otherwise not paid attention to. Because, you know, he's a peasant, whatever. Marie Antoinette meets up with her lover, who tells her how risky it was to come here and to share an embrace and, you know, the whole spiel. And, and let me think of how this exactly goes down, because I don't remember all the details. Something happens, and then it doesn't go exactly as planned. And, I really don't know whose art style I have kidnapped for this to happen. But, anyway, something goes down. Marie Antoinette is on, is in danger of getting revealed. There is some trouble. Renan wakes up. And he's a bit confused what's going on, he has no idea. Again, he has just woken up, and you know, sure. Gamma, who was the very mysterious figure, super mysterious, nobody knew who he was, that followed the queen. He has noticed trouble as well, but he also sees Ronald, who is confused, barely awake, and a perfect person to blame all this ruckus on. So, his lackeys, who I'm not going to draw because that's going to be a lot of work, but his lackeys take Ronald, and he tells, Ramar tells Alambre that the queen was in danger, but now she's safe. The revolutionary, which was clear by the red scarf and some papers Ronan had on him. Ronan will be taken in and everything will be fine. He will be taken to the Bastille for being revolutionary and a traitor to the crown, and Olympe should take the queen back to Versailles, where she will be safe and everything will be fine. Olympe has seen it all go down, and she has seen that Ronan wasn't really responsible for anything, so she protests a bit, but she can't do too much. So she thinks to herself that she will do as suggested. She will put the queen back home, and then later she will talk to her father, who is the head of the guard at the Bastille, to let Ronan go. And everything is fine. Ronan is taken in. He is protesting, but he has no idea what has just happened, but he's now being taken into the Bastille. Thank you, Troy. It's hard to give eyelashes to people with the dot eyes. So, did I even, I mean, I didn't even let the song go, so let's do that first. There you are. There. Yeah. So you have the song between Ronan and... Does Olympe sing? Yes, Olympe does sing in this song. And then, you know, Ronan is confused, but he has also seen a pretty lady, so he is also thinking of her, but you know what? He's a revolutionary, he can't do much, he's being taken in. He has no idea what is going on, really. And Olympe feels the same, really. No idea what's going on, but she will try to get this innocence out. Yes. And that's where we get the next scene. Maybe. Maniac. We go to the Bastille. And For those who don't know, Bastille is a pretty important prison. And Renard gets taken there, he gets put in a cell, and there he meets a rather familiar figure who he doesn't really like to see again. Because, you know, you don't really want to be reminded of the time your whole village got, burned down to the ground, pretty much. This is... I don't know how this quote goes. If you know what I... Probably just guess. Sincerely doubt that, miss. But we'll see. Oh god. What if I just... I think I would accept... your comment as the truth if I didn't like change style every single drop. And gave him like really long hair. He has like really long hair, so just being like, this doesn't make sense. So we are reintroduced to Lazar, who basically tells Bonon that he really, like, after seeing his village get like pretty much burned down and people killed, they really should have been more careful and not like join a revolution. And can't imagine that Ronan isn't. I've never felt more attached to a drawing. Are you kidding me? Noon and Slim. So yeah, Renahun is again not happy. So far he has been happy 0 times during this adventure. But you know, he has pretty legit reasons to be unhappy. I have no idea what this aesthetic is, and I'm glad you guys are into it, but I have no idea what I'm doing. Still has its scarf and some coats, whatever. Like this drawing. It's like kind of anime-ish. Which is kind of funny to me, but you know. So yeah. I don't know what else to draw. Oh, pardon me. But so yeah, they have a conversation. Lazar tells Renan that he should never join the revolution. And that is pretty much the song suggests a maniac for even like trying to like change anything. If it wasn't clear already, Lazar is pretty like aristocratic. He has the kind of payroll. Guess I'm like drawing prison cells. Yeah. let me put on the song. Pretty interesting style when it comes to us. That sounds about right. Where is money? There. I love this guy's voice so much. Oh, just all his songs, really? I don't know. I mean, his voice is also really good, but his songs make it all worth it. This is what prison cells look like, right? Just like big, like rectangles, squares on a wall, like bars. Definitely what prison cells look like. And you get the idea. Should probably have like there. Don't know what the lock is attached to, but that's there now. Now it's not the place. Glad you're taking so many notes. Yes, I'm glad I could help. let me check which song is up ahead. Okay. Let's, so we have, this whole song and then. Meanwhile, Olamp, talks to her father, who, as I said, is the head guard of the Bastille, probably some sort of aristocrat or another, and he, she asks him, well, I was there, she says to him, well, I was there when it all went down, this guy, Ronan, didn't do anything. We could probably let him go and it wouldn't be any trouble. He's just a peasant, so, you know, you should really let him go. And, Lump's father almost gives in. But before that, Ramar, comes in with orders from the king's brother that the revolutionary should be executed. Chris, shut up. You can draw really quickly, it always impresses me. Like, just, you guys are both great. You're all great. You're all great artists. where was I? Emperor comes in with the orders for Ronan's execution. And Lalpa hears this and thinks, oh no, he's going to be executed. It's all my fault, really. I should get him out. I should let him escape, so to speak, because I can't really do anything about the whole execution thing, but maybe if I help him escape, then he'll be gone and nothing really will happen, he's just a peasant, whatever. Ramar talks to Alamba's father, because Ramar has a bit of a crush on Alamba, because, you know, he's a villain, so he must do all the things bad. So he sees this as an opportunity to talk to Alamba's father about, you know, possible engagement or something. So that kind of distracts them both a bit, and Alamba goes down in the Bastille and searches for Ronan. She finds him, but he is not that happy to see her, because he recognizes her. And he recognizes her as the girl who was there when he got caught, and who didn't do anything. Who actually... Yes, I now remember, but who really even, like, got him caught in the first place. Like if she hadn't said or done anything, he would have escaped. Oops, put that knife away. Put the knife away. Now. Doesn't fit, Lessa, your character, so. You better. or you're no longer Lessa. Lamper convinces, Ronan, mostly by saying, they're going to come here to execute you, and they will make sure that the only way that you will ever see daylight again is by, well, not see daylight, but that your body sees daylight again by lying face down in the river. Ronan quickly agrees after that, because he might be stupid, but he is not stupid enough for death. He doesn't want to die, pretty much. Pretty legit reason, really, to accept help from Orlando. So he goes along, she opens his prison cell with the keys she stole from her father, and as Ramar and his lackeys arrive at the prison cell, they find it empty, and thus they realize that Lampa must have helped, so they go on a chase. Because they want to fight the revolution there, because otherwise the Count of Artois is going to be angry at everyone because they don't follow his orders. So that's the plan. No. Yeah. Sorry, accidentally created another extra layer that I didn't. And Olante helps Ronan escape, and they meet outside. And they pretty much like go their own way after that, but not before Charlotte. Remember her, the little girl who was around. Yeah, she is there as well. Ronan has gone out ahead of Olympe, and Charlotte says that she will make sure he will be safe, because Charlotte assumes that Ronan and Olympe are lovers, and Olympe denies this because, of course. And yeah, I don't know what this hand position is. So we now have Ronan, who has escaped and who will join the revolutionaries again in their hideout, I guess. It's not really a hideout because it's not really hidden, but like they hide Ronan in their like printing press room. Printing press building. You know what I mean? Once both Charlotte and Ronan are gone, Lampe sings the song Les Amants, as you do. almost forgot about her little bird. She still has a gun, but I'm not going to draw that now. Listen, I'm just, I love, like, sorry for that noise. I am really bad at, like, keeping my art, consistent and simple. And so I'm just going to get more and more complex as we go. And there's nothing I can do about it. But it does result in me actually like being happy with drugs. So can't be too oh, I need to change that. I really can. That's better. And then also, I just want to make this, like, good. Like, not really as in, like, good drawings or anything, but more like, give you guys something good to look at as I tell this story. And I don't really know yet what, like, is important. I guess. Or Noka. Well, thank you guys. I mean, I like the compliments, but, I don't really know how to say what I want without seeming like I want attention, but, I'm not very, I was pretty, like, not really scared, but really nervous, because So far I haven't really done anything like this, and Chris has. But I don't really know anyone else who has done something like this. So that's pretty much the only example I have. And like, I don't really, I really didn't know what to expect from this, because like the things we have done with Chris is like very like different. Like Final Fantasy, it like all still has like room for like your guys' input, which like I wanted to have that for this as well, but I didn't think it would have really worked out well. So I want to give myself these guidelines, and yeah, I don't know. I didn't really know what to do or expect or anything. Like, what quality of drawings am I going to do? Because I'm not great at improvising. Like, I really admire that about Chris. Like, funny drawings and improvisation are clearly things he excels in. As I will ramble, I'll put him in the song. I know I need to figure out what makes this fun for me, but and that's the main bit of a thing, because it also needs to be fun for you guys. Because if you guys aren't having fun and aren't interacting as much, I am not having as much fun. So it's a bit of a balance act, and I don't really know for sure yet where I land. Yeah. I mean, that's kind of the thing as well, because I've given you guys like characters. Like, I, before this drawthrough even started, I gave you guys like who I thought you guys would be in this. Which like bits like weird maybe, but not like weird, but and the, just I want to tell this story because I want you guys to know why I gave you guys these characters, or like what their story is. Like, the reason why Miss became like, I hadn't given anyone Selene yet, but also just when I really began to think about it, it really just fits Miss, like, as someone who, like, just doesn't take shit from anyone, not even, like, own family. Just, like, I need to do this. Like, Selene is strong, and Miss is also strong. like not really like caring about like expectation from society, because she just needs to be she just does what needs to be done. And like that, there are like reasons for pretty much everybody why I chose. Sorry to call you out, Chris, but you're like that's just it. I'm no shitting this. Let's move on. But like there are reasons for everybody, and yeah, from the start really I tried to make sure everyone fit their character really. Like Oops and Lazare also really had like similar feels and yeah, aesthetic to me. Like strong and cool and really just like doesn't really care about protests or others. They're going to do their own thing. Just yeah, like that Dantal is like pro for real, and like both aesthetic and just like general not really like caring, like pretty much anarchy like feel to them. I don't know what I'm trying. I don't know if I know who I'm drawing. So let's start with that. And like just very like happy. Like Au Palais Royal is very like upbeat song, and that fit the crowd, but also like but also there is a serious trick about Danton, which is like really he wants to do the right thing, which I think is very cool. He has a reason why he is in the like he is a revolutionary. He may not seem like it, but he is a revolutionary, and he takes that actually pretty serious. and Elias. Well, I'm always happy to say those words, yes, because they're very true. Like, no, you don't want to hear it, but what I said is true. They're really strong, and I really admire that. But I can analyze Oops further if you want. If you don't want the attention, and I will instead go to Oops, because like I mean Azar doesn't have a very big role on in the musical. Like well he does appear on screen a lot, and he has like a lot of songs and such, but his character isn't one of the things that gets developed. He's just there as opposition, really. But like you have to, like, give or take, give and take, as you, I'm not saying that Oops is a position or anything, but, like, he has, like, a really, like, cool determination to him. Like, it's hard to put into words, really. You do oppose. Okay, sorry, forgive me. But it's, like, hard to put into words, but it just fits. I need to concentrate on this. But it just fits Oops so well. And also just because they're both, like, really cool. Like, that's for sure a thing. And then, well, Oops, you're just going to have to become less cool for us to be convinced that you're less cool. Because we're just seeing the truth, which is that you're really, really cool. I don't know what I'm going to do with this post, so he's just going to be shrugging, I guess. Let's see. Kuro is one I only, like, gave a character later. I don't know why you weren't one of the first people I gave a character to, because you were already around, so I don't know what happened there. But even though it's been so long and it really, like, shouldn't fit anymore, it's still like the character still really fits, I think, because Lampa is, like, really a genuinely kind person. Like, apart from, like, the actress too, along being absolutely beautiful, she's also just, like, very kind and protagonistic and sweet and everyone in the project. And, like, Kuro is really just one of the sweetest people ever. Like, and you can disagree with that, Kuro, but we all know it's true. You can't escape it. You really just are always, like, out there supporting people. And you're just really kind, and he loves you for that. You're great, just like everyone is great. Yeah, exactly. Kuro is the angel and the demon at times, but still mostly angel. Just being so nice and what everybody needs. Even if you're not always feeling well. Even if you have your own stuff to deal with. That will help you. Because you deserve it. Because you're kind. I'm just rambling at this point. anyway. Character announced. Or maybe I should first say what exactly I'm drawing. Nah, it can wait. Thanks for all the stickers. I really have no idea what these stickers do, or they're just there for aesthetic, but I like them. He had like a low, like almost like piratey. He is no longer wearing a pajama. Sorry, miss. I always draw next too long. What kind of thing? Alright, character analysis. I was going to talk about Try. Because, like, Try is going on to a T, I think. Like, just, like, shouty and, like, out there. But still, like, you know they're, like, fighting for the right thing. Maybe not the way you would do it. But that's okay. Everyone has their own way of fighting. Yeah, exactly. Try is very sweet in the way that he is a shouty man, and we love him for that. He is a shouty man, and he fights for the right thing, and you know he has a good heart. The shrugging pose really has nothing to do with what is happening in the musical, but I really don't know what else to do. miss, I love that because these are probably the only good hands I have drawn this whole time. Have you seen the other hands I've drawn? They're just like non-existent. Like, are you sure? You just gotta commit to it. I mean, that's true, but usually they're supposed to have something to do with what is happening. Not this time. He has, like, hair. I mean, that's pretty obvious. But, like, he has, like, hair that makes it seem like he has short hair, but then he doesn't. Like, it took me a while to figure out that he had like a ponytail. Because it really doesn't look like it. Because it looks like slick back short hair, but it isn't. There you have it, man. That's what most of my hands look like when I draw them done. I can't draw hands. I swear. Like, I usually need like a lot of reference for hands because I can't draw them to save my life. It's a bit like this. Anyways, maybe you guys want to know who I'm drawing. Just maybe. Just maybe. Anyway, this is Maximilian Robespierre. Otherwise known as the guy who I pointed me. For reasons unknown to me, but like, whatever. Thought he was cool, guess. Wanted to give myself a cool character. That's probably what happened. I don't really know what reasons. My brain probably has come up with reasons, but I don't know. You are cool. No, no. 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 Anyway, you have like this. I don't remember what it looks like. It's like, looks like I'm drawing a guillotine. I'm not drawing a guillotine, I promise. Oh, how are the tables up there? No. No. Not true. Also, I swear I'm not drawing a guillotine. I don't remember what it looks like. It was something like this. I don't know. It's a printing press. What do this look like? Look like a giant table. I don't know, it's just a spoon. Anyway, I should probably say what's up. First, let's put on the song as I explain what's up. We have Ronan escapes the Bastille with the help of Lampe and Charlotte, and Charlotte brings him back to the revolutionaries, and they are happy to see him again, and they hide him from the peoples who are after him, because he's still in trouble. There is some talk because Ronan wants to get Ronan wants to get out of there again, but the others don't want him to because he's being looked after. We are met with a new revolutionary, this mister. He is Robespierre, also known as the guy who went crazy and beheaded everyone during the actual revolution. But you know what, that's not happening yet, and I don't know why I'm shading this, but whatever. Ronan gets a bit mad at Robespierre. They get in a bit of an argument because Robespierre just like all the others is a bit of a bourgeoisie, not really a peasant, just the rich citizen wants more rights, like most, but doesn't really get the worst of it. But the Ronan is a peasant and he does get the worst of it. He has experienced the worst, and he doesn't think the other revolutionaries get it. So they get in a bit of an argument with Ronan, arguing that they need to do more for the peasants. But Maximilien, answers that that isn't really a possibility at this point in time, because peasants are scared and can't really do much, and they're already kind of being compromised and everything isn't going too great. But they're trying their best and that's what matters. But Ronan doesn't really see it that way. I can't get out of that one. It's because I said he beheaded everyone, isn't it? They get in a bit of an argument, and Danton has to break them apart and remind them they're fighting on the same side, really, so they should focus on getting that first. And they get in a bit of an argument, Danton breaks them up, and they sing a song, because this is a musical, and they sing Hey Ha, because that's what it's about. They're going to start a revolution, and that's what Hey Ha is about. I don't know why I like this one. I don't know, I think it looks pretty good. Yeah. Wait, let me check a thing. Okay. I don't think I've already gone on for so long. And I don't think I can do another scene. Also because I'm going to have to remind myself of what happened here, and that's going to take a while. So I think I'm going to end the stream here, and we'll see what happens the next time. We have unfortunately not arrived at the end of the first act, which I hoped for, but you know, things happened and went a bit rambly and whatever. So we'll let's get a quick summary and then we'll end. quick summary of what happened. We went through the opening. We met our main characters, who were living outside of Paris as peasants, and they got their village and pretty much like torn apart, and the citizens like killed by soldiers from the king, and the king didn't do anything, so they're a bit angry. Oh god, the quality of my drawings has really gone up the stream. But we then went to Versailles. I just looked at the sky again. I can't. We then went to Versailles to see like the how big a difference there is between how big a difference there is between the two like sides really. We met our other main character, Olam, and the queen and the spy, and the queen went out to meet her lover in Palais Royal, followed by Olam as guide and safety keeper, and followed by a spy, courtesy of her brother-in-law, I guess. We then went on to meet the revolutionaries, Dumoulin, who I still really don't really care about. Renault was with the revolutionaries. Danton is here, he arrived with a bang, and little Charlotte. And we meet them, we see that Renault is pretty unsatisfied with the whole thing because lack of help for peasants. So already like a bit grumpy, but then he figures out that his sister has, because of his negligence, has decided to become a whore and get buy her own stuff. They got in a bit of a fight because he doesn't want her to be a whore, she wants to eat. They split ways. During the night, Renan is sleeping outside because he's homeless after his village was attacked. And something goes wrong. Renan is taken to the Bastille because he was discovered to be a revolutionary. There he gets talked down by Lazare, who pretty much says that could have gone much better, shouldn't have gotten into trouble. He was helped out of his cell by a lamp after he was threatened to be executed. He was then brought to the revolutionaries by little Charlotte, and that's where we are now, with the meeting of Robespierre. Yeah, that's pretty much what happened. We'll leave it off here. I had a good time. Yeah. I don't know. I'm not sure if I've ever thrown anything like this in my life, but now it has happened. But I think it was all pretty fun and pretty good. I hope you guys all enjoyed it. I hope you all feel more informed and will continue to be more informed about this musical. And see you guys next time, I guess. Let's put on a good song to end this with. And Chibi? Chibi. Also, thanks for the sticker, Chris. Chibi, Chibi. Aw. Thanks for you too. You guys are so sweet. I see you all guys in Discord. Bye everyone. Bye bye.
Assez de nous flatter, de nous jeter comme des jouets. À trop jouer à celui qui ment, ils ont trahi ton serment. Songe à toutes les galères dont on ne peut plus se défaire. L'enfer, c'était hier.